What is the deadliest animal in the world? Is it the lion, the shark, the grizzly bear? It's none of the above. Believe it or not, the animal that kills a lot of people every year, more than 1 million, is the puny mosquito. To set the record straight, it's not the mosquito that actually kills, but the parasite or the virus it carries and transfers to the human it bites. The malaria parasite, carried by the female Anopheles mosquito, is responsible for the majority of deaths attributed to the insect. According to the World Health Organization, about 300 million to 500 million cases of malaria happen every year, with one child dying of it every 30 seconds. Most of these deaths are recorded in Africa. Also fatal, if not treated properly, are the dengue fever and the West Nile virus that mosquitoes carry. Fortunately, not all mosquitoes are deadly. In fact, even in places where mosquitoes can become carriers of viruses or parasites, just about 1 in 500 does so. And it's only the females that have the capability to infect people by biting them. They need to consume blood for the energy required to produce eggs after mating. Male mosquitoes, on the other hand, are not bloodsuckers since their staple diet is the nectar of flowers. But even when mosquitoes are relatively harmless, just giving us an itchy rash instead of a deadly disease, they can be irritating at the very least. Their constant buzzing near our ear can really give us some sleepless nights. Why do they do it? We have got the explanation, of course. But before we give it, please don't forget to give a thumbs up to this video. Also, click on the subscribe button so you can get your daily supply of fun and informative videos. We may have some major gripes about mosquitoes, mainly because they cause deadly diseases, but to be fair, we really can't fault them for their buzzing near our ears. It's not like they are attracted to our ears and deliberately fly towards them. Incidentally, that buzzing we hear at a frequency of 450 to 500 Hz is just the sound of the mosquito's wings, beating quite rapidly, about 500 times per second. The reason why we hear it so close to our ears is because it happens to fly really close to our ears while it circles our head. The buzzing sound is quite soft, so when the mosquito is not near our ears, we couldn't hear it. So definitely, the insect is not targeting our ears. Instead, it is attracted to the carbon dioxide that we exhale through our mouth and nose. The gas is an irresistible smell for female mosquitoes and makes them crave for blood. They need it to circle our heads several times so as to zero in on the source of the carbon dioxide. So that's why mosquitoes buzz in our ears. They are also guided by our body heat and use their sense of taste to tell whether the source of blood is human or animal. Some research has shown that female mosquitoes are most attracted to type O blood. Additionally, a person's genes and diet can also affect how yummy they can be to a mosquito. Also, people wearing dark-colored clothes seem to attract mosquitoes more. Why then don't we hear that mosquito buzz every time since we always exhale carbon dioxide? It turns out that to mosquitoes, we have a more attractive body part than our head, and that is our feet. Our feet have bacteria that emit a smell that mosquitoes simply love. The bacteria, called Brevibacterium linens, gives off an odor that is similar to the smell of Limburger cheese. A study made in 1996 proved that Anopheles mosquitoes, specifically, are drawn to the smell of our feet. Another study in 2013 showed that Limburger cheese actually attracted mosquitoes. With mosquitoes being the deadly insects that they are, why is there no worldwide effort to eradicate them once and for all? There have been some tests done toward that goal. Scientists from the Oxford University modified the genes of the males of the Aedes aegypti, that mosquito that carries the dengue fever and the Zika virus, so that their offspring would not be able to reproduce. They then introduced these altered males in an area on the Cayman Islands. The result was a success, as the mosquitoes on the site were reduced by 96%. Unfortunately, this is not feasible on a worldwide scale because it would need millions of altered mosquitoes just to affect a small area. Also, these insects play a part in the world's ecosystem, and totally eradicating them could have dire consequences on the balance of nature. Did you enjoy this episode of So That's Why, and find it quite informative? Let us know in the comments section below. Please don't forget to like it and to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.